Welcome to Galactic Science with Nemgo.
Where slimes can breathe in space.
Whee! We're in space!
Please.
This mod get off pack, the roof. This mod pack is created by people, and their names and links are in the description. Links to the Feed the Beast forums.
We did our research, didn't we, Nem?
We did our research and couldn't pronounce one of the names, so we thought it best not to pronounce just Kathleen and the other one.
Is that not the one that we couldn't pronounce?
No, the other one we couldn't pronounce. Well, at least we couldn't understand what it was supposed to sound like. So rather than saying just Kathleen made Galactic Craft Science, we decided it's just Galactic Craft Science made by people. Links in the description. Thank you very much.
Could be Martians.
Could be Martians. I like the way we move. I like the way you... I like the way you walk. Your arms and stuff move slightly differently.
I'm gonna shut the door. Awesome. There's a crazy man. There's a crazy man.
Only you could shut the door. This is a very strange survival-based mod pack. For a start, we've got oxygen and limited amounts of it. We've got food and limited amounts of it. We've got quests in the form of the HQM quest book. And we've got to try and get through those. We've got a tree. We've got
we've got
place.
Sand.
We've got some sand. We've got a bed. We've got mine chem to make things happen. And downstairs, we've got a Galactic Craft oxygen thing that makes oxygen.
Got this.
But has no power. And we've got this thing over here, which is something to do with this thing, which is supermassive tech.
Super techy sexiness.
And that's a star harvester. I'm sure we will understand how all that works.
Can you go there and like order a pint and have some food?
The harvester.
Yeah.
It's not a restaurant, is it? It's a machine for harvesting stars.
I just
thought
we could go there and like, you know, maybe meet Arnie.
I'd rather go to the little chef.
Showing your age there.
But anyway, folks, we better get cracking on because, like I say, we're up against it. We've got limited oxygen and all that kind of stuff. We're going to start with whatever the quest book tells us and then veer off like we love to do from there.
I've just put 3D mode on because, like, I'm cool.
We've got two quests done. What's this all about? Okay. We've got ignition and liftoff. Earth is doomed. Grab your rocket and embark to the emergency station on the moon. Okay, we've done that. We're here. We're on the moon. This is the startup. So it's giving us some freebies at the start. Do we want to do our group quest things? Let's party up. No, but
neither do I.
I'm going to make it up as I go along then. I'll create a party called Nemgo, and it's life settings, shared lives, reward settings, multiple rewards. We'll do multiple rewards just to make it a bit quicker for the viewers to see us progress? Or do you want to make it hard for us?
Let's make it easy. Let's do it normal.
Okay, so we both get the rewards, which will make it slightly quicker for us to progress through the pack. We're not here to grind in front of the camera. Invite player...
But can we twerk?
Can we twerk in front of the player?
Can we talk? Twerk.
Okay. I've sent you an invite, so now you receive the invite and we should be on the party.
The invite says... No, you don't do that. Except...
Okay, so we are now in a party. Okay, so now we're in a party.
Now joined in holy matrimony.
Oh, thank you. And now, if we get these rewards, we should both get them, yes? So, the ignition one. This is like our starting kit that we get. We get a star. We get some cans of food. We get some heavy oxygen tanks and an energy conduit. Claim it. Wow. I just lost slowness and mining fatigue. Maybe because I'm holding a brown dwarf star. Wow! I'm holding a brown dwarf star.
Yeah.
You see it? It gives you mining fatigue for holding it. Wow.
If I paint it red. Does that mean it's a red dwarf star?
Do you remember in Crash Landing where we called our party Red Dwarf?
Yeah.
Or was it Blue Dwarf?
I think it was Blue Dwarf.
Blue Dwarf. I think we called ourselves Blue Dwarf. Or Blue Midget. That was it, Blue Midget, which is also from Red Dwarf, if people know what Red Dwarf is in the series.
Yeah, they're now all thinking, what the hell are they talking about?
For the next quest, the heavy oxygen tanks we've just been given
Yeah.
Those give us the charcoal or another oxygen tank. Well, I think as we've got like 8 oxygen tanks now, I think
we're going to lose 2.
Why are we going to lose 2?
They're not going to take them for this quest.
No, you don't have to hand them in.
Ah, okay.
Says in top right.
So should we pick charcoal?
I'm claiming charcoal, yes. Because we've got more than enough of the tanks to be able to do refueling of ourselves, aren't we? The dwarf star, though, that's like the first part of supermassive tech thing going on there. And I have no idea how supermassive tech works yet. But there is another quest in the line, wield the power of the stars. Okay, I'll read it. And we'll see if we can understand what to do with it, okay?
Yep.
Well, okay, it's a small star you've got there. I should think so, because I've got it in my pocket, for one. Not to say a dwarf, but we can use its power in the emergency system. Quickly find the emergency system and locate the star container. That's that thing that you had earlier, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Then insert the container followed by the star into the harvester. Okay, and that gave us a claim reward. I'm going to pick the bone crook, and if you get the extra piece of dirt, then we've got an extra piece of dirt. Because we've already technically picked that up, haven't we?
Yep.
So, do you want to do the honours of blowing the place up?
Yeah, why not?
Because from what I could see of this, it was something weird going on. Harvest the powers of stars, outputs at the rate of the star inside. Activate venting mode by shift right-clicking the top face. Must be upright. Once the star is out of power, it will go critical. Better run.
Bye.
Once the star is critical, it doesn't say what we do with it. It doesn't say what we do with it when it breaks. But that is giving power to the oxygen collector. So it's already hooked up underneath the floor somehow.
Magic.
That'll be where this pipe goes down into the floor.
It's magic.
It goes up and underneath there. So that's connected already, which is good. It's connected to the energy storage as well, which means that we should be able to put our tanks in the energy storage and fill them up. Yep, it's doing that job. So we need to get a chest down here that we can put our oxygen tanks in. So as it creates oxygen, which it'll just do automatically, constantly, because this tree does it, it will use this power from the dwarf star and we'll have oxygen supply.
Have you got that crook?
Yes, I've got a crook.
It's a crook.
Do you want to crook that tree out there?
We'll crook this tree.
I'll get the bottom block of wood because I like the message that comes up. It's really quiet on the moon. Our game sounds aren't really low or anything, is it?
No. No. Oh, no, it's a firework. Oh, wow, fireworks work on the moon.
Fireworks work on the moon? That's good, isn't it? I'd got a worm and now I couldn't break the wood with a worm.
Yeah, Nemzin's got worms.
That's for the ex Nihilio.
I got
everything rolls around all over the place. Okay, I got wood. That's awesome. Okay, so fireworks on the moon. Awesome. We've got to get started by making sieves and things like that as well. I don't think there's any tinkers in this pack, so I don't think we've got any tinkers to do. But I just want to make a... Wow, there's four place... There's Europa, Oi, or whatever. Mercury, Pluto, Venus. There's a wormhole. There's extra planets as well as the galactic craft basics like the moon and Mars and those.
Have you created the light got the light oxygen tank?
Have I created the light oxygen
tank? No, have you claimed it, sorry?
Claimed? Let me see. There to Messi. Which one is that? I've already claimed that.
The figure.
The figure? Fail? No. That is wrong dimension for me, right? Because you started on the overworld. Let's just be frank about it, and had to get up here in order to play through from where we're supposed to begin. So Ego got all of the galactic craft stuff, came to the moon, and because he was in the wrong dimension, he got this fail quest completed.
Have you made a crafting table?
Not yet, no.
I'm going to make one.
Okay. Trees on the moon, we make a wooden axe, and we get some more oak saplings and a stone axe. And there is tree capacitor in... You stop letting off fireworks in the house. There is tree capacitor in this pack as well. I'm going to make a chest out of my wood and put it downstairs by the oxygen creator so we can have something transferred.
Oh, I should have picked saplings then.
What?
I picked...
That's full. That's good.
Take this one out. Shall I make another tree?
Yeah, do more trees. Do more trees. I'm going to put the full oxygen tanks and empty oxygen tanks in the chest by the oxygen compressor. Okay, so you know where to find oxygen when you need it. I've still got a fair amount, so it's good now at the minute. So we get the trees on the go. We got some bone meal from something as well, don't we? Yeah, I got some bone meal. I want to set a tree out somewhere a bit further away, a little bit further away, that we can set up for string in the ex nihilo fashion. I've got one of those worms that the bone crook gave out. So I'm going to set that up and just have that growing over here. So we can get straight onto string and sieving and stuff. So put the silkworm in there and leave it. If we just... Well, we're just going
to
need...
We need to get a magnet.
We need to what?
Get a bloody magnet of some sort.
That's a good point. Yeah, good idea. Yeah, we can make other bits and pieces like crooks and stuff out of things.
I've just claimed the vacuum cleaner. Okay.
Moon turf.
So we need to make a sieve then. Are we anywhere near making a sieve?
No, because we need the string first.
Do you want to use this? I've got bone meal here. Have you got bone meal?
I've got some bone meal, yeah. There was a quest to get a wooden axe. You've already done that, haven't you?
Yep.
So I get a stone axe and you get one. I claim the dirt because that's better than anything else in it. And with tree capacitor, we can go on from there. Vacuum cleaner, you've got the turf, which means we've got a shovel. Awesome. It's quite quick to get started, isn't it? Oak sieves, the next.
So weird not having sound, though.
Yeah, because we get the sound of things going on, don't we? But we don't get the sound, as in actual real sound, as we're doing stuff. We get the HQM quest reward sounds. How come the tree capacitor didn't work when I pressed shift?
Because that's...
not supposed to. Oh, man, look at him.
That's vein miner.
Vein miner, that's right. Yeah, that's what I've been used to doing, vein miner, in my race to the moon, and now I'm on the moon, I can't use it anymore. Good job.
Bang. I'm going to guess it's just normal standing up, since it's taking me forever to break this.
You hit the bottom block, yeah. And then it all floats around all over the place. It's crazy. The moon and gravity. It's awesome how they managed to put gravity in Minecraft, though.
Yeah, it's cool.
But we do need something of a magnet at some point when we've got some bits and pieces to do things. Would be nice. We've got some apples now as well. We could eat apples. I don't know why we got started with the canned apples. I guess that's just to promote the feel of us being... in space.
Lost in space, but on the moon.
Yeah, lost in space, but on the moon. I'm going to make another chest for wood supplies as well. And another chest for miscellaneous stuff that's going to clog up our inventories if we don't. So I'll put a chest next to the crafting bench for miscellaneous. And I'll put a chest out here, right there, for saplings, bone meal and wood supplies and stuff, okay? And I'll put apples in there as well. By the crafting table, I think I'll just chuck in the cans of food that I'm not holding on to. So
yeah, that sounds like
and
plan
the dwarf that. Star as well. I'm going to put that in there because I don't really want to carry that around with me. The energy conduit, that will be useful for something a bit later. And a spare quest book. All that kind of crap can go in there. That's fine. We've got to worry about night time as well on this place. So perimeter defences, well, it's already losing lots of time. We have very long days and very long nights on the moon. Right? So mobs spawning on the moon is very, very hostile. And they can bounce. What was that come from?
How high can they bounce?
I just got a tin canister arrive. Where did that come from? Did you throw it?
No.
Tin canister just landed from nowhere.
How high can they jump?
How high can they jump? They can jump a few blocks the same as we can. They've got no gravity the same as us.
Right, so if I can't jump it, then they can't jump it.
I think we should just block our door off during the daytime.
Yeah, but then we're going to be stuck inside, aren't we?
Yes. We have a bit of a wall around the trees, I suppose, if that's what you're planning. We're going to have a bit of space. We can fight some of them off if they come over the wall.
I am fighting nothing off. I'm scared.
You don't be that scared. Come on.
I'm terrified.
Another thing is torches don't work in the moon.
No,
so
they need to be that glowstone.
We don't light anything in the moon either, so that's no good. Right, the oak sieve. Let me see if I can get something going with a crook. And
I've got another silkworm here, by the way.
That's good. I'll have that off you in a minute then. I'm going to get three crooks and go and deal with this tree. In fact, if you give me the silkworm, I can get a second tree going before the first one gets knocked down.
It's about four more that way.
You don't take any fall damage, though, at least. That's pretty good.
Yeah, I suppose that's good. Especially the amount that you...
The amount that I fall, is that what you're about to say?
Especially like...
It's not my fault, man. It's not my fault. Okay, so we want two trees that are close enough together. They're always like two blocks out there. Close enough together so that they can have this all going on if you want them to.
I like the dirt, the moon dirt.
Moon turf and stuff.
No, moon dirt.
The actual dirt bit, yeah.
I like the texture of it.
It's not bad, is it? Galacticraft's got a lot of cool textures in overall. It's quite nice. But I think we've got to go all around the world and and all that. We've got to go to all the different planets. I think the
can we call you Mr. Fog?
Phileas Fogg, and we go round the world in 80 days. Yeah. Well, we technically go round the world every day because we're on the moon.
But not in an air balloon.
Not in an hot air balloon, no. We go round the world in every day because we're on the moon and we're travelling very, very fast. But that's by the by. This is not a science lesson. This is galactic science, which basically is Minecraft modded up to give us all sorts of weird things that we can do and try and survive on the moon.
We got this, baby. We got this.
Yeah. Let me see. Is that fully infested? Yes, it is. That's one piece of string. Fully infested. Yes, it is. Okay. Well, we've got a little bit of grinding to do to start this series, as we do for every single Minecraft series. But I have a feeling that we're going to be able to get progression through here fairly quickly. The end tech, the tech that's like Uber, at the end, all the way through, there's apparently, we haven't experienced this yet, but there's apparently a very good set of tech tree difficulty. So we can't unlock some of the future tech, big, massive, awesome technology until we've been to some of the other planets. Like certain blocks and things don't become available to us until we've been to other planets.
Which, we can go on and explore.
Well, we're going to have to make rocket ships and go off and all that kind of stuff, explore the galaxy.
Well, where's the one I came in? Where's the one you came in?
Technically, the one I came in blew up, and the one you came in, well, you just forgot to pick it up.
Well, I'm sorry. How about the one that the storybook wrote?
The one that the storybook says we came on. Yeah, I know.
Oh, they could still get
over. I don't know. Maybe it gives us one during the questing at some point. I don't know. But I do have a little bit of string now, so I'm going to see if I can make the sieve and get started on that. We've got a bit of sand down here as well.
Yeah,
We need to sieve up to the point where we've got things like seeds and stuff, don't we? So let me remind myself on sieving technology. Sieve. It's a IEVE. That's it. We do have the automatic sieves on here as well.
They rock.
They're rock amazing. And roll, they do. I need four more silk, four more string. But this tree's nearly done, so I'm good with that. If only they weren't floating around. I think that adds a little bit of extra difficulty. Everything like you're harvesting flows around and you got to harvest it like that.
How are we going to get cobble?
Boom. By getting stone through the sieve. Those little stones, you remember?
Oh, yeah.
Way back when we started.
Totally remember, not at all. I mean, yeah, I do.
Yeah, you get those little bits of stone and you put them together to make your first bit of cobble, and then we make something to make a cobble gen, and then we do something else. And
so
yeah.
Can we sieve moon dirt?
Yes, I think you can. I think that's a meant to be.
Because otherwise it's going to have to be, we're going to have to... Yeah. How are we going to do it? Because we won't be... Oh, I don't know.
We won't be able to get rainwater and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, there's many little problems that...
We're going to die!
Hopefully we can solve. The pack's been built around this principle. So I'm hoping that we don't have to worry too much about these kind
of
things.
We have to worry. We're playing it.
Yeah, well, that's okay. We can do this, Ego. We can do this.
I know I can. Oh, whoops.
Wood and sticks. That's easy enough. I can manage this. See? Wood and sticks. That's all I need.
Nailed it.
Nailed it. I can do this. It's like vanilla Minecraft on the moon. It's easy.
Ooh, what's that?
Okay, got a sieve. I'm going to put the sieve next to the chest by the crafting bench for now and see if I can sieve moon turf. Yes, she can sieve moon turf. Da-da-da. And I got some glowstone from
something.
It.
Found something then.
I got two pieces of glowstone and a piece of flint from sieving moon dirt.
Why is that there?
That's pretty awesome, isn't it? What have you found? Anything good?
I found a chiseled block.
A chiseled block? Well, the base is made of chiseled blocks.
Yeah, but I'm not next to the base. Well, I am, but...
Oh, that's probably a marker for, like, copy-pasting as a template. Like this one over here, this moon rock over here. I think there's four moon rocks, one on each corner, so I think they were sort of templating where they were going to put the base so they could copy-paste it into the world save when they were creating the map. I think that's all those are. But now we've got some moon turf. I will just sieve up a bit more moon turf and check things out. It didn't look like you could decompose the moon turf because there was nothing under the microscope that gave us any sort of mine chem stuff. So it's only really useful for doing such and such. Oh, we get silicon dioxide from flint, though. That's good. So the flint is a good resource. Bone meal, we get titanium dioxide, which is... Meh, I don't think I know what that needs. I don't know what that is exactly. There's some that I know are fairly useful. Like carbon, for instance, from charcoal. So a tree farm and all that kind of stuff is cool. I think one of the first quests that we go into is probably going to be progressive automation. Because you've got your death potato, haven't you?
That is amazing, that death potato. It haunts me forever.
It haunt you forever and ever and ever and ever. Well, still at least you've got a death potato.
Just that one comment. One comment.
Just one little comment and you've got a death potato every one time you do everything.
One slightly stereotypical comment.
Yeah. Well, what can I say? The only things that I've got from doing moon turf at the minute has been glowstone, redstone, flint, bone meal and gunpowder.
Can you not use glowstone to make torches though?
I don't think you can make glowstone torches. Yes, you can, because that's galactic craft.
Nailed it.
Nailed it. Well done. So we can light up around the area with glowstone torches. Da 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 da. Let's F7 this. F7's not working?
Don't say that.
Is F7 not a thing? Please be a thing, F7?
No, there was one version of Forge, weren't there, that wasn't playing nicely with it.
Okay.
Guaranteed that we're on that
one. Maybe that we're on that one, yeah. We're on the version of Forge that doesn't like it. I'm just grabbing all the moon turf that you've left lying around.
Yeah, I was coming back for that.
And we can just light bits of the wall and things like that. I'll just put a few torches down. It's got to make a difference. Maybe F7 just doesn't work on the moon.
Maybe.
Maybe that's a thing. I thought it did, but could be mistaken. I just put a few on there.
Oh, not mistaken then.
Because we do have a lot of resources on the moon, don't we? Because we've got a lot of things that we can get. One of the things that I do want to start off with is a pick to go and get those fallen meteorite bits, because they have some cool bits in it.
I've cocked my base up. I've cocked my wall up.
Start again. Oh, it's moon dirt that makes stone.
Okay.
Moon turf, the topsoil, makes all of the interesting materials, and moon dirt makes the stone that we need to make cobblestone. And I haven't seen any clay or anything like that yet for us to be able to make a crucible. That's the word, isn't it? We need to make a crucible.
We
are going to need to make a crucible, aren't we? Unfired crucible, porcelain clay. Clay itself is synthesized. We can synthesize it. Or we can sieve moon rock. We sieve moon rock with a chance of getting clay. So, moon rock, is that something that you've seen already? Apart from those four that are just lurking around.
Yeah, there was some down with that... That chisel block.
Okay. So the under surface.
It's the underbelly.
The underbelly of the beast. I want to keep checking my quests as well. Oh, look at that. I just made a pickaxe, and the reward for the oak sieve is stone pickaxe. Jeez. Oak barrel to decompose stuff to get other bits. That big ball of dirt is still floating above you, and here you struggle for some. Get a barrel and compost your surplus saplings into it. Don't waste your last ones. So, yeah, we make an oak barrel to compost things, and that's it for that section. But I'm going to get some of this moon rock. And, whoa, there's another meteorite just dropped down. We've got to be careful of that as well, you know.
Yeah, do you know what else we've got to be careful of?
Mobs, because it's going to get dark soon.
Running out of stuff.
Running out of things. Running out of oxygen.
No blocks. Oh,
I'm going to pick up all these blocks that have just been dropped on the floor thanks to a meteor hitting the ground very quietly.
What do you like for food?
I've got loads of food. I put a load of spare food in the chest by the crafting bench.
I've not eaten anything yet.
It doesn't seem to be doing much for my my health right now. It doesn't seem to be doing anything at all. I possibly haven't been doing as much work as you. This fallen meteor does not look like it wants to break with a stone pick. I'm going to carry on breaking it until it
can we get moon
out of existence.
Can we get moon? No, you've got to let him cool, haven't you?
Yeah, I'm letting the other one cool. Oh, this one looks like it's been here for a while. But it also looks like I'm just going to break it and it's going to disappear. I don't think this is the right tool level for the job. But I'm just going to experiment, because it might just take a long time with a stone pick. It might. So viewers, don't be shouting at me.
Shout at him.
This is an experiment to see if I can claim these with a stone pick, or whether it just breaks them. There's plenty of them around, and there will be plenty more.
There won't. But it's our only one. You're wasting it.
It's the only one. It may just take a very long time.
It's the Highlander of the game.
I'm just seeing. Just checking. Before we go around and collect them all, I want to see if I'm wasting 10 minutes of my time. Because it's taking a very long time. Yeah, it's just broken. Okay, so yeah, that's not a good thing to do. Don't bother trying to use the stone pick on meteorites. But I am going to collect all of this rock that we need for a bit as well. Because, well, that's going to be useful. Also, we need to maybe start digging underneath the base. Just so that we've got a nice safe place under the base.
Well, get me a tinker's pick, the upgrades.
A tinker's pick, so you can just... Yeah, I don't think
we've got... The quarry 9001.
We need a quarry, that would be
1002.
Nice.
1002.
We've got Ender.io, so we've got kind of a quarry.
Yeah,
but
it's
not the quarry. Man, you're doing a good job of building a big, massive wall around here.
Yeah, that's... I'm future-proofing it.
You do have a long day ahead of you, because we're about halfway through the moon's day. We're about to have a very long moon night.
So how many more torches have we got?
I can just sieve a load more of this stuff and make a load more torches. So I can do that very quickly, very soon. I'm just getting some more string. I think if we had two sieves, then during the long nights when we're cozying on down together, we can just say thank you very much for watching and just get to sieving everything.
Are you
together.
Sieving dirt or are you sieving turf?
I'm sieving whatever I've got in my inventory.
I've got some... Well, where you're over there. What's best?
The turf was for good stuff like the glowstone, and the dirt, I think, was for the stone, which we're also going to need for making
there's
cobble.
There's 31 behind you.
And it's the moon rock.
The sky or somewhere.
I just grabbed some moon rock so that I could get started on making the crucible, so we can make... Well, get clay to make the crucible... So that we can start making lava for lava power and all that kind of stuff. Hopefully.
Go down.
I'll put those in there. Yeah, that'll do. All right, so moon rock. Let's see if I can
see. That's what
moon
we
rock.
Need to watch. Yeah. Does what? This thing use energy?
What?
When there's a full tank in there. You know, like the oxygen tank?
Maybe it does, yeah. Okay, this moon rock didn't give me anything. Twice. Don't be three times. Three times.
Can we make a hopper? Two hoppers. Will that work?
Four times and I got a coal. Wow, that's bad. That rock, I had to put four pieces of rock in before I got one piece of coal out of it.
Ooh.
That's terrible. Are you doing your oxygen?
Yeah, I'm just swapping the tanks around.
Okay, is there a full one in there at the minute?
Just about to be. Okay. Just 2 seconds. 3 seconds. 20 seconds. It's on the floor.
It's floating around behind, the room somewhere.
It's behind the thing.
Alright, well, we've got a good start. That's not too bad, is it? We've got a good start. I'll just...
I thought I heard a gas then, but it's your cat.
My cat in the background, oh my did you God. Hear that? Must want feeding.
Oh, that's scary.
Or letting out, or some more milk or water or something. It must be ready for something. Shut up, cat.
It's not bull, Will.
Alright, well, are we about done for this episode? Just a nice little introduction. Yeah? I think so. Well, thank you all very much for watching this first episode in a new dramatic Nemgo series. The Galactic Science, full of, well, reminiscent mods from our crash landing days together. And
cats that pretend they're gas.
Cats that are gas. Well, the gas noise was actually a cat, wasn't it? But anyway, thank you all very much for watching. We're going to grind out a little bit more, finish off building the wall, and possibly survive the first night. And see you in the next episode. Thank you very much for watching. Say goodbye, Ego.
Goodbye, Ego. Go.
So it's good now at the minute. So we get the trees on the go. We got some bone meal from something as well, don't we? Yeah, I got some bone meal. I want to set a tree out somewhere a bit further away, a little bit further away, that we can set up for string. In the Ex Nihilo fashion. I've got one of those worms that the bone crook gave out. So I'm going to set that up and just have that growing over here. So we can get straight onto string and sieving and stuff. So put the silkworm in there and leave it. If we just... Well, we're just going
to
need...
We need to get a magnet.
We need to what?
Get a bloody magnet of some sort.
That's a good point. Yeah, good idea. Yeah, we can make other bits and pieces like crooks and stuff out of things.
I've just claimed the vacuum cleaner. Okay.
Moon turf.
So we need to make a sieve then. Are we anywhere near making a sieve?
No, because we need the string first.
Do you want to use this? I've got bone meal here. Have you got bone meal?
I've got some bone meal, yeah. There was a quest to get a wooden axe. You've already done that, haven't you?
Yep.
So I get a stone axe and you get one. I claim the dirt because that's better than anything else in it. And with tree capacitor, we can go on from there. Vacuum cleaner, you've got the turf, which means we've got a shovel. Awesome. It's quite quick to get started, isn't it? Oak sieves, the next.
So weird not having sound, though.
Yeah, because we get the sound of things going on, don't we? But we don't get the sound, as in actual real sound. As we're doing stuff, we get the HQM quest reward sounds. How come the tree capacitor didn't work when I pressed shift?
Because that's...
Not supposed to... Oh, man, look at him!
That's vein miner.
Vein miner, that's right. Yeah, that's what I've been used to doing vein miner in my race to the moon, and now I'm on the moon, I can't use it anymore. Good job.
Bang. I'm going to guess it's just normal standing up, since it's taking me forever to break this.
You hit the bottom block, yeah. And then it all floats around all over the place. It's crazy. The moon and gravity. It's awesome how they managed to put gravity in Minecraft, though.
Yeah, it's cool.
But we do need something of a magnet at some point when we've got some bits and pieces to do things. Would be nice. We've got some apples now as well. We could eat apples. I don't know why we got started with the canned apples. I guess that's just to promote the feel of us being... In space.
Lost in space, but on the moon.
Yeah, lost in space, but on the moon. I'm going to make another chest for wood supplies as well. And another chest for miscellaneous stuff that's going to clog up our inventories if we don't. So I'll put a chest next to the crafting bench for miscellaneous. And I'll put a chest out here, right there, for saplings, bone meal and wood supplies and stuff, okay? And I'll put apples in there as well. By the crafting table, I think I'll just chuck in the cans of food that I'm not holding on to. So
yeah, that sounds like
and
plan
the dwarf
that.
Star as well. I'm going to put that in there because I don't really want to carry that around with me. The energy conduit, that will be useful for something a bit later. And a spare quest book. All that kind of crap can go in there. That's fine. We've got to worry about night time as well on this place. So perimeter defences. Well, it's already losing lots of time. We have very long days and very long nights on the moon. Right? So mobs spawning on the moon is very, very hostile. And they can bounce. What was that come from?
How high can they bounce?
I just got a tin canister arrive. Where did that come from? Did you throw it?
No.
Tin canister just landed from nowhere.
How high can they jump?
How high can they jump? They can jump a few blocks, the same as we can. They've got no gravity the same as us.
Right, so if I can't jump it, then they can't jump it.
I think we should just block our door off during the daytime.
Yeah, but then we're going to be stuck inside, aren't we?
Yes. We have a bit of a wall around the trees, I suppose, if that's what you're planning. We're going to have a bit of space. We can fight some of them off if they come over the wall.
I am fighting nothing off. I'm scared.
You don't be that scared. Come on.
I'm 25.
Another thing is torches don't work in the moon.
No,
so
they need to be that glowstone.
We don't light anything in the moon either, so that's no good. Right, the oak sieve. Let me see if I can get something going with a crook. And
I've got another silkworm here, by the way.
That's good. I'll have that off you in a minute then. I'm going to get three crooks and go and deal with this tree. In fact, if you give me the silkworm, I can get a second tree going before the first one gets knocked down.
It's about four more that way.
You don't take any fall damage, though, at least. That's pretty
good.
Yeah,
I suppose that's good. Especially the amount that you...
The amount that I fall, is that what you're about to say?
Yeah, especially like...
It's not my fault, man. It's not my fault. Okay, so we want two trees that are close enough together. They're always like two blocks out there. Close enough together so that they can have this all going on if you want them to.
I like the dirt, the moon dirt.
Moon turf and stuff.
No, moon dirt.
The actual dirt bit, yeah.
I like the texture of it.
It's not bad, is it? Galacticraft's got a lot of cool textures in overall. It's quite nice. But I think we've got to go all around the world and eat charcoal or another oxygen tank. Well, I think as we've got like 8 oxygen tanks now, I think
we're going to lose 2.
Why are we going to lose 2?
They're not going to take them for this quest.
No, you don't have to hand them in.
Ah, okay.
Says in top right.
So should we pick charcoal?
I'm claiming charcoal, yes. Because we've got more than enough of the tanks to be able to do refueling of ourselves, aren't we? The dwarf star, though, that's like the first part of supermassive tech thing going on there. And I have no idea how supermassive tech works yet. But there is another quest in the line, wield the power of the stars. Okay, I'll read it. And we'll see if we can understand what to do with it, okay?
Yep.
Well, okay, it's a small star you've got there. I should think so, because I've got it in my pocket, for one. Not to say a dwarf. But we can use its power in the emergency system. Quickly find the emergency system and locate the star container. That's that thing that you had earlier, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Then insert the container followed by the star into the harvester. Okay, and that gave us a claim reward. I'm going to pick the bone crook. And if you get the extra piece of dirt, then we've got an extra piece of dirt. Because we've already technically picked that up, haven't we?
Yep.
So, do you want to do the honours of blowing the place up?
Yeah, why not?
Because from what I could see of this, it was something weird going on. Harvest the powers of stars, outputs at the rate of the star inside. Activate venting mode by shift right-clicking the top face. Must be upright. Once the star is out of power, it will go critical. Better run.
Bye.
Once the star is critical, it doesn't say what we do with it. It doesn't say what we do with it when it breaks. But that is giving power to the oxygen collector. So it's already hooked up underneath the floor somehow.
Magic.
That'll be where this pipe goes down into the floor.
It's magic.
It goes up and underneath there. So that's connected already, which is good. It's connected to the energy storage as well, which means that we should be able to put our tanks in the energy storage and fill them up. Yep, it's doing that job. So we need to get a chest down here that we can put our oxygen tanks in. So as it creates oxygen, which it'll just do automatically, constantly, because this tree does it, it will use this power from the dwarf star and we'll have oxygen supplies.
Have you got that crook?
Crook. Yes, I've got a crook.
It's a crook.
Do you want to crook that tree out there?
I will crook this tree.
I will get the bottom block of wood because I like the message that comes up. It's really quiet on the moon. Our game sounds aren't really low or anything, is it?
No. No. Oh, no, it's a firework. Oh, wow, fireworks work on the moon.
Fireworks work on the moon? That's good, isn't it? I'd got a worm, and now I couldn't break the wood with a worm.
Yeah, Nemzin's got worms.
That's for the ex Nihilio.
I got
everything rolls around all over the place. Okay, I got wood. That's awesome. Okay, so fireworks on the moon. Awesome. We've got to get started by making sieves and things like that as well. I don't think there's any tinkers in this pack, so I don't think we've got any tinkers to do. But I just want to make a... Wow, there's four place... There's Europa, Oi, or whatever. Mercury, Pluto, Venus. There's a wormhole. There's extra planets as well as the galactic craft basics, like the moon and Mars and those.
Have you created the light... got the light oxygen tank?
Have I created the light oxygen
tank? No, have you claimed it, sorry?
Claimed? Let me see. There to Messi. Which one is that? I've already claimed that.
The figure.
The figure? Fail? No. That is wrong dimension for me, right? Because you started on the overworld. Let's just be frank about it, and had to get up here in order to play through from where we're supposed to begin. So Ego got all of the galactic craft stuff, came to the moon, and because he was in the wrong dimension, he got this fail quest completed.
Have you made a crafting table?
Not yet, no.
Right, I'm going to make one.
Okay. Trees on the moon, we make a wooden axe, and we get some more oak saplings and a stone axe. And there is tree capacitor in... Will you stop letting off fireworks in the house? There is tree capacitor in this pack as well. I'm going to make a chest out of my wood and put it downstairs by the oxygen creator so we can have something transferred.
Oh, I should have picked saplings then.
What?
I picked...
That's full. That's good.
Take this one out. Shall I make another tree?
Yeah, do more trees. I'm going to put the full oxygen tanks and empty oxygen tanks in the chest by the oxygen compressor. Okay, so you know where to find oxygen when you need it. I've still got a fair amount. I know what that needs. I don't know what that is exactly. There's some that I know are fairly useful. Like carbon, for instance, from charcoal. So a tree farm and all that kind of stuff is cool. I think one of the first quests that we go into is probably going to be progressive automation. Because you've got your death potato, haven't you?
That is amazing, that death potato. It haunts me forever. It
haunts you forever and ever and ever and ever. Well, still at least you've got a death potato.
Just that one comment.
Just one little comment and you've got a death potato every one time you do everything.
One slightly stereotypical comment.
Yeah. Well, what can I say? The only things that I've got from doing moon turf at the minute has been glowstone, redstone, flint, bone meal and gunpowder.
Can you not use glowstone to make torches, though?
I don't think you can make glowstone torches. Yes, you can, because that's galactic craft.
Nailed it.
Well done. So we can light up around the area with glowstone torches. Da 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 da. Let's F7 this. F7's not working?
Don't say that.
Is F7 not a thing? Please be a thing, F7?
No, there was one version of Forge, weren't there, that wasn't playing nicely with it.
Okay.
Guaranteed that we're on that
one. Maybe that we're on that one, yeah. We're on the version of Forge that doesn't like it. I'm just grabbing all the moon turf that you've left lying around.
Yeah, I was coming back for that.
And we can just light bits of the wall and things like that. I'll just put a few torches down. It's got to make a difference. Maybe F7 just doesn't work on the moon.
Maybe.
Maybe that's a thing. I thought it did, but could be mistaken. I just put a few on there.
Oh, not mistaken then.
Because we do have a lot of resources on the moon, don't we? Because we've got a lot of things that we can get. One of the things that I do want to start off with is a pick to go and get those fallen meteorite bits, because they have some cool bits in it. some cool materials.
I've cut my base up. I've cut my wall up.
Start again.
Start again.
Oh, it's moon dirt that makes stone.
Okay.
Moon turf, the topsoil, makes all of the interesting materials, and moon dirt makes the stone that we need to make cobblestone. And I haven't seen any clay or anything like that yet for us to be able to make a crucible. That's the word, isn't it? We need to make a crucible.
We do.
We are going to need to make a crucible, aren't we? Unfired crucible, porcelain clay. Clay itself is synthesized. We can synthesize it. Or we can sieve moon rock. We sieve moon rock with a chance of getting clay. So moon rock, is that something that you've seen already? Apart from those four that are just lurking around.
Yeah, there was some down with that... that chisel block.
Okay. So the undersurface.
It's the underbelly.
The underbelly of the beast. I want to keep checking my quests as well. Oh, look at that. I just made a pickaxe, and the reward for the oak sieve is stone pickaxe. Jeez. Oak barrel to decompose stuff to get other bits. That big ball of dirt is still floating above you, and here you struggle for some. Get a barrel and compost your surplus saplings into it. Don't waste your last ones. So, yeah, we make an oak barrel to compost things, and that's it for that section. But I'm going to get some of this moon rock. And, whoa, there's another meteorite just dropped down. We've got to be careful of that as well, you know.
Yeah, do you know what else we've got to be careful of?
Mobs, because it's going to get dark soon.
Running out of stuff.
Running out of things. Running out of oxygen.
No blocks. Oh,
I'm going to pick up all these blocks that have just been dropped on the floor thanks to a meteor hitting the ground very quietly.
What do you like for food?
I've got loads of food. I put a load of spare food in the chest by the crafting bench.
I've not eaten anything yet.
It doesn't seem to be doing much for my my health right now. It doesn't seem to be doing anything at all. I possibly haven't been doing as much work as you. This fallen meteor does not look like it wants to break with a stone pick. I'm going to carry on breaking it until it
cracks
out of existence.
Can we get moon? No, you've got to let them cool, haven't you?
Yeah, I'm letting the other one cool. This one looks like it's been here for a while. But it also looks like I'm just going to break it and it's going to disappear. I don't think this is the right tool level for the job. But I'm just going to experiment because it might just take a long time with a stone pick. It might. So viewers, don't be shouting at me.
Shout at him.
This is an experiment to see if I can claim these with a stone pick or whether it just breaks them. There's plenty of them around and there will be plenty more.
Well, it's our only one.
Welcome to Galactic Science with Nemgo.
Where slimes can breathe in space.
Whee! We're in space!
Please.
This
Oi,
mod
get off
pack,
the roof.
This mod pack is created by people, and their names and links are in the description. Links to the Feed the Beast forums.
We did our research, didn't we, Nem?
We did our research and couldn't pronounce one of the names, so we thought it best not to pronounce just Kathleen and the other one.
Is that not the one that we couldn't pronounce?
No, the other one we couldn't pronounce. Well, at least we couldn't understand what it was supposed to sound like. So rather than saying just Kathleen made Galactic Craft Science, we decided it's just Galactic Craft Science made by people. Links in the description. Thank you very much.
Could be Martians.
I like the way we move. I like the way you. I like the way you walk. Your arms and stuff move slightly differently.
I'm gonna shut the door. Awesome. There's a crazy man.
You could shut the door. This is a very strange survival-based mod pack. For a start, we've got oxygen and limited amounts of it. We've got food and limited amounts of it. We've got quests in the form of the HQM quest book, and we've got to try and get through those. We've got a tree, we've got a place.
Sand.
We've got some sand, we've got a bed, we've got mine chem to make things happen. And downstairs we've got a galactic craft oxygen thing that makes oxygen.
Got this.
But has no power. And we've got this thing over here, which is something to do with this thing, which is supermassive tech.
Super-techy sexiness.
And that's a star harvester. I'm sure we will understand how all that works.
Can you go there and like order a pint and have some food?
The harvester.
Yeah.
It's not a restaurant, is it? It's a machine for harvesting stars.
I just thought we could go there and, like, you know, maybe meet Arnie.
I'd rather go to the little chef.
Showing your age there.
But anyway, folks, we better get cracking on because, like I say, we're up against it. We've got limited oxygen and all that kind of stuff. We're going to start with whatever the quest book tells us and then veer off like we love to do from there.
I've just put 3D mode on because, like, I'm cool.
We've got two quests done. What's this all about? Okay. We've got ignition and liftoff. Earth is doomed. Grab your rocket and embark to the emergency station on the moon. Okay, we've done that. We're here. We're on the moon. This is the startup. So it's giving us some freebies at the start. Do we want to do our group quest things? Party up? Yeah, let's do it.
Okay,
let's party up. No. But
neither do I.
I'm going to make it up as I go along then. I'll create a party called Nemgo, and it's life settings, shared lives, reward settings, multiple rewards. We'll do multiple rewards just to make it a bit quicker for the viewers to see us progress? Or do you want to make it hard for us?
Let's make it easy. Let's do it normal.
Okay, so we both get the rewards, which will make it slightly quicker for us to progress through the pack. We're not here to grind in front of the camera. Invite player.
But can we twerk?
Can we twerk in front of the player?
Can we talk? Twerk.
I've sent you an invite, so now you receive the invite and we should be on the party.
The invite says... No, you don't do that. Accept.
Okay, so we are now in a party. Okay. So now we're in a party.
Now joined in holy matrimony.
Oh, thank you. And now, if we get these rewards, we should both get them, yes? So, the ignition one. This is like our starting kit that we get. We get a star. We get some cans of food. We get some heavy oxygen tanks and an energy conduit. Claim it. Wow, I just lost slowness and mining fatigue. Maybe because I'm holding a brown dwarf star. Wow, I'm holding a brown dwarf star.
Yeah.
You see it? It gives you mining fatigue for holding it. Wow.
If I paint it red, does that mean it's a red dwarf star?
Do you remember in Crash Landing where we called our party Red Dwarf?
Yeah.
Or was it Blue Dwarf?
I think it was Blue Dwarf.
Blue Dwarf. I think we called ourselves Blue Dwarf. Or Blue Midget. That was it, Blue Midget, which is also from Red Dwarf, if people know what Red Dwarf is in the series.
Yeah, they're now all thinking, what the hell are they talking about?
For the next quest, the heavy oxygen tanks we've just been given.
Yeah.
Those give us the IAA and all that. We're going to go to all the different planets. I think the
Can we call you Mr. Fogg?
Phileas Fogg, and we go round the world in 80 days. Yeah. We technically go round the world every day because we're on the moon.
But not in an air balloon.
Not in an hot air balloon, no. We go round the world in every day. Because we're on the moon and we're travelling very, very fast. But that's by the by. This is not a science lesson. This is galactic science, which basically is Minecraft modded up to give us all sorts of weird things that we can do and try and survive on the moon.
We got this, baby. We got this.
Yeah. Let me see. Is that fully infested? Yes, it is. That's one piece of string. Fully infested. Yes, it is. Okay. Well,
get up.
We've got a little bit of grinding to do to start this series, as we do for every single Minecraft series. But I have a feeling that we're going to be able to get progression through here fairly quickly. The end tech, the tech that's like Uber...
At the end.
At the end. All the way through. There's apparently, We haven't experienced this yet, but there's apparently a very good set of tech tree difficulty. So we can't unlock some of the future tech, big, massive, awesome technology until we've been to some of the other planets. Like certain blocks and things don't become available to us until we've been to other planets.
Which, we can go on and explore?
Well, we're going to have to make rocket ships and go off and all that kind of stuff, explore the galaxy.
Well, where's the one I came in? Where's the one you came in?
Technically, the one I came in blew up, and the one you came in, well, you just forgot to pick it up.
Well, I'm sorry. How about the one that the storybook wrote?
The one that the storybook says we came on. Yeah, I know.
Oh, they could still get
it. I don't know. Maybe it gives us one during the questing at some point. I don't know. But I do have a little bit of string now, so I'm going to see if I can make the sieve and get started on that. We've got a bit of sand down here as well.
Yeah,
we need to sieve up to the point where we've got things like seeds and stuff, don't we? So let me remind myself on sieving technology. Sieve. It's IEVE. That's it. We do have the automatic sieves on here as well.
They rock.
They're rock amazing. And roll, they do. I need four more string. But this tree's nearly done, so I'm good with that. If only they weren't floating around. I think that adds a little bit of extra difficulty. Everything like you're harvesting flows around, and you got to harvest it like that.
How are we going to get cobble?
Boom. By getting stone through the sieve. Those little stones, you remember?
Oh, yeah.
Way back when we started.
Totally remember, not at all. I mean, yeah, I do.
Yeah, you get those little bits of stone and you put them together to make your first bit of cobble, and then we make something to make a cobble gen, and then we do something else. And
so
yeah.
Can we sieve moon dirt?
Yes, I think you can. I think that's a meant to be.
Because otherwise it's going to have to be, we're going to have to... Yeah. How are we going to do it? Because we won't be able to get
rainwater and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, there's many little problems that
we're going to die.
Hopefully we can solve. The pack's been built around this principle. So I'm hoping that we don't have to worry too much about these kind
of
things.
We have to worry. We're playing it.
Yeah, well, that's okay. We can do this, Ego. We can do this.
I know I can. Oh, whoops.
Wood and sticks. That's easy enough. I can manage this, see? Wooden sticks, that's all I need.
Nailed it.
I can do this. It's like vanilla Minecraft on the moon. It's easy.
Ooh, what's that?
Okay, got a sieve. I'm going to put the sieve next to the chest by the crafting bench for now and see if I can sieve moon turf. Yes, she can sieve moon turf. Da-da-da, and I got some glowstone from
something.
It.
Found something then.
I got two pieces of glowstone and a piece of flint from sieving moon dirt.
Why is that there?
That's pretty awesome, isn't it? What have you found? Anything good?
I found a chiseled block.
A chiseled block? Well, the base is made of chiseled blocks.
Yeah, but I'm not next to the base. Well, I am, but...
Oh, that's probably a marker for, like, copy-pasting as a template. Like this one over here, this moon rock over here. I think there's four moon rocks, one on each corner, so I think they were sort of templating where they were going to put the base. So they could copy-paste it into the world save when they were creating the map. I think that's all those are. But now we've got some moon turf. I will just sieve up a bit more moon turf and check things out. It didn't look like you could decompose the moon turf because there was nothing under the microscope that gave us any sort of mine chem stuff. So it's only really useful for doing such and such. Oh, we get silicon dioxide from flint, though. That's good. So the flint is a good resource. Bone meal, we get titanium dioxide, which is, I don't think.